Hey guys, happy new year and welcome back to my channel. So as you would already know from the title of this video, I am committing myself to a low buy year, and I'm gonna start it off with a no buy January. Okay, now before I go into that, if you haven't seen my video on what's it called, Raw and Real, where I admitted to being a shopaholic, I'm gonna link that in the cards over here and maybe at the end of the video as well for you to be able to see that, so that you will understand where this is coming from. There were a few things and that has happened. I have achieved my goal in that video, which was to end the year debt-free. So that did happen, and it ironically happened on Black Friday, where instead of putting the money that I saved and put aside for shopping, I used it to pay off my credit card. So that was a big win for me. But even though that was a big win for me, I noticed that because I had achieved that, I wanted to reward myself. And that being said, I think that kind of mindset of rewarding myself for achieving something that should be a reward in itself, it didn't sit right with me. And I knew that it was wrong. Logically, I knew that it shouldn't be the way, but I still did it anyway. So I kind of like spent the whole of December and the holiday period thinking about like, what do I actually want to do for 2020? I put out a resolutions video, which I'm going to link in another card somewhere on the screen. I put out a resolutions video that I was going to, let me just go back to those resolutions because I saved that on my Instagram highlights. So I did say that I was going to restart my low carb life, then work my way back to keto. So today is day one, 1st of January. I have been intermittent fasting since midnight, so it's been about 11 hours since the last time that I ate. So I'm starting my low carb life. We've actually already like filled the fridge with food that would help me with that. So January would be pretty much low carb. It's not gonna be keto. Mainly because it's my birthday month, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to eat out or maybe even have cake. So I'm gonna be low carb for most of the month, if not every day of the month, with the exception of my birthday. I also did say there that I was going to do a 31-day dance challenge in January, which if you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen me already post my ridiculously awkward dancing to Backstreet's Back, I think is the song, because I was following a Zumba medley of 90s music, and yeah, that was one of the songs that was on there, and it was the least awkward dance. So that's what I posted, because you know, we all just want to show off the best that we can do on social media, and that was my best. Okay, so I did that this morning. It was the first thing that I did from when I got up, and after I brushed my teeth, I did a dance and then I showered. The next one is to stop popping into thrift stores, and this actually leads to one of my points in my low buy, no buy challenge for the year, because I found myself getting bored oftentimes, especially during the weekends. Like, because I work from home, I tend to want to go out during the weekend, and I find that I would pop into thrift shops and charity shops and whatever you call it where you're from, and browse, but still end up buying something that I probably have multiples of already or don't really need, but buy it because it's cheap, or buy it because it's from a certain brand. So and justifying that purchase that it's sustainable and I'm keeping it from going into the landfills, but it's still causing clutter in my closet. Okay, the fourth resolution was to sell, swap, donate. So I've actually been updating my my Facebook marketplace and my eBay. Now there's gonna be a little bit of a change on there, because I think I might remove the eBay app from my phone. But I would still obviously be able to do it on my laptop. But the thing is, when I have it on my phone, I tend to browse for things that I don't need. And I will talk a little bit more about that. And then the last one, the last resolution, is to save and invest. So I did say in that resolutions video that I wanted to save up $1,000 every month, because I want to, I have a property back in Manila. It's a condo unit that I want to get renovated at the end of the year, or maybe around August when I do go home for that. And maybe also pay off a little bit more of the mortgage to shorten the time that I have to pay for it. So I do have that goal in mind. So now I am, like I said, I am committing to a low buy year, not a no buy year, because I know myself. And I, being too restrictive on myself is only going to make me want to do the stuff or buy the things even more, and I would end up obsessing over it until I get it, and then the moment that I get it, the thrill is over and it's just gonna sit in my closet. I know me well enough to do that. So the first thing that I am doing is acknowledging this problem, which is why I did that video about me being a shopaholic. So acknowledge that I do have a problem. I do have a problem of impulse buying. I do have a problem of being trigger happy when it comes to swiping my card and things like that. And so acknowledging that is, I guess, the first step in resolving this issue that I have of myself and my financial capacity. Okay. And changing the mindset. Exactly what I said. I knew myself, and I know myself, and I know that this is my tendency, and I have seen me do this repeatedly, and I have caught myself and stopped myself from doing it. If you remember a few videos ago, I said that I really, really wanted to have a Chanel bag, a double flap classic Chanel bag. And so I have actually been obsessing over that for the entire month of December and November. I don't even remember when I started doing that. The mindset that, oh, if I just get this one item, then I would stop and that would be enough for me and I would be okay. But it doesn't stop. Honestly, it doesn't stop. So at first I said, oh, my dream luxury item is to own a Louis Vuitton bag. Louis Vuitton. I don't know. I think that's how it's pronounced. I don't know. So I wanted a Louis, okay, in other words. And then I found a way to get a Louis more affordably and more accessible for me, which is to order it secondhand pre-loved from Japan, okay, where I would be guaranteed of its authenticity and I would get it, you know? So I did. I did get my Louis Vuitton, and you know that because I've posted an unboxing of that where I was so excited. And where is this Alma bag right now? It's sitting on my closet. I used it once. I haven't used it since. So that, you know, that feeling that I really, really, really want this, and then you finally get it, and then it's like, okay, now I have it. Now what? So that mindset of really, really wanting something and obsessing over something and then finally getting it and then realizing I don't actually want it or need it. Like, that's happened to me a few times that I ended up reselling the stuff that I bought because I realized I don't really want it. I shouldn't have to feel embarrassed about not buying something when I realize that I don't want it or I don't need it. And yet I do. And that's happened to me a lot of times where I end up buying something, let's say even from the market, just because I've already asked the salesperson a lot of things about it. I've already taken so much of their time that the only way that I can compensate them is to at least buy one thing, even though I didn't need that one thing. So, yeah. Okay. That was a long number one. Number two, remove triggers and find inspiration instead. I also know myself, and I know that this has been effective for me when it came to makeup. When it came to makeup, I started unsubscribing to YouTube beauty gurus. I started unfollowing beauty influencers on Instagram, and that worked for me. I haven't bought makeup in a long time. I mean, for somebody who loved makeup so much, the last item that I bought, I believe, was the Pat McGrath Trio, the mini ones. That was the last thing, and that was back in April. Okay, so I've now what I'm doing, because I know that I have this thing about bags and brands and clothes and stuff. So I'm actually removing triggers from my social media. I'm following YouTubers who do a lot of thrifting. I'm following Instagrammers who do a lot of thrifting and then reselling those thrift items. I'm following, because I started following a lot of this replica accounts, and also I started following a lot of this Japan secondhand designer luxury accounts. I started unfollowing them. I think I started just before Christmas. I was like, okay, that's enough. Anyway, so I've started to unfollow these accounts, both on YouTube and on Instagram. And instead, what I've done, starting, I think, when I went home, which is the 15th of December, I've started pinning outfits on Pinterest. And what I intend to do is to look at my closet and reenact, is that the right term? Or be inspired by those outfits and try to do it with the things that I already have in my closet. And you'll probably see a few videos here and there of me recreating, that's the right term, recreating those outfits with the things that I have. And one of my inspirations for that is Miss Belle Temple, or Elisa Belle Temple on YouTube, because she is a stylist, and what she does is she looks at Pinterest pictures and she recreates that, and she breaks it down to like, what's the texture, what is the purpose of the item of clothing, what does it do for that person's body and stuff like that. And then she finds something in her closet that she could use to recreate that look. So that's something that I intend to do, so that I, instead of shopping in the op shops or charity shops, I'll shop my closet instead. So you would see, if not on YouTube, you would see it on Instagram. I would be posting some of those things. Okay. Set a goal and make yourself accountable. So in one of my resolutions, I said that I wanted to save and invest, and I wanted to earn or to set aside $1,000 every month for savings, because my goal is to have my unit renovated. Okay, so I would do that, and how I would do that is I'm actually going to do a spreadsheet of how much I have saved every month, and I'm also thinking about doing an inventory of all of the clothing items and all of my bags that I have, so that, because I find that I end up buying things because I forget that I already have them, you know. So I think that is what I'm going to do, and I'm going to give you like maybe a quarterly update on that thing, on those two things, like my savings and my inventory. The inventory of clothing would also help me to not only curb my shopping because I would know exactly what I have in my closet, but I would also maybe list on there when was the last time I used that item of clothing, so that I know that if I hadn't actually used it for like 6 months, I would have to revisit that and think about whether I should still keep it or if I should send it to a new home. Okay, so that's one thing. And to make myself accountable for that, I would be updating you, like I said, on a quarterly basis. Now, there would be exceptions to this low buy, which is like January is my birthday month. It's going to be a no buy for me. But if somebody would give me a gift card to use, or would, and also during my, what do you call this? My birthday celebration, I intend to invite my friends and treat them to dinner. So that's technically not a buy, because I'm not getting anything material out of it, but more like the companionship and celebrating my birthday. So yeah, exceptions would be gift cards, or if I'm gifted certain items. So there we go. But yeah, realistically, and then probably when I have to buy a gift for Duncan because his birthday is in April, or if I have to send flowers or a gift to my in-laws because their birthday is in August and in July, and a gift for my mom because her birthday is in May. So like gifting to other people, I would make that as an exception. But for myself, no. I would also set aside a budget for me to, because this is gonna be a low buy and not exactly a no buy. In January, because I spent so much during my trip in the Philippines, I am doing a no buy. So I'm not buying myself anything in January. And then from February onwards, it's gonna be a low buy, but I'm gonna set aside a budget of $100 for the month, not for the week. For the month, to buy maybe one thing that I really, really want. But for me to be able to decide if I really, really want it, I would have to hold off for 7 days. Upon seeing that item and deciding that I want it, I have to hold off for 7 days. If that item is still available, then I can buy it after 7 days, or if I'm still thinking about that item after 7 days, because I find that after a day or two, I already forget. Like if I see something that I like, if I don't really love it or I don't see a purpose for it, I find that after 3 days I've completely forgotten about it and I don't even want to buy it anymore. So I'm gonna give myself 7 days, double the usual time, to think and contemplate about whether or not I really want to buy that and spend that $100, okay, on an item. The other exception would be that if I don't spend that $100 that month, it can roll over to the following month or whatever is the remainder. Let's say I only spent $50. The other $50 can roll over to the other month for a budget. And that way, at the end of the year, if there was a big purchase that I wanted to buy, I could use that budget that I've set aside for the previous months to purchase that one big item. Okay. And I think the last rule that I am going to be using here is asking for help. One of my subscribers commented in a previous video, I think it was like in my resolutions video. Well, she asked me if I had considered going for counseling for my shopping addiction. And I said, I don't think I am in that bad of a situation just yet. I mean, the fact that I acknowledge that I have a problem, I think is already the first step, but there's nothing wrong with asking for help. And if I find that I am overwhelmed already, or I find that I am having like anxiety attacks from not being able to buy something that I want to buy, but something that I shouldn't be buying, then I think that would be a reason for me to be seeking out help, whether professionally or with like friends or family, to like give me a reality check, I guess. All right, that was a really, really long introduction to my low buy year. But if you have done a low buy month or a low buy year or no buy month or no buy year, please leave me some tips in the comment section down below. I have been following Style Apotheca who has been doing, who's done a no-buy year, and Hannah Louise Poston, I think is her last name, who's also done a low-buy or no-buy year challenge. So they were the two that have inspired me to do this, and I will keep you updated on a quarterly basis on how I have done this, but future videos would probably include some Pinterest-inspired outfits. All right, let me know. Thanks, bye.